All right, we're back for one more example of dealing with shifts in supply and demand and non-price determinants. And the last one that I'd like to come to is sort of a two-part problem. And let's start by examining the foreign car market. So we're looking at the foreign car market, and what we're trying to do is to determine what's going to happen if Obama, say the president, raises taxes on imported cars. So he's worried about the U.S. market, you know, U.S. car market becoming bad, and so he's going to put taxes on the foreign car market. How does that play out in our models of supply and demand? Well, taxes. Taxes are one of those non-price determinants on supply. So when you tax something, what's the first thing that happens? Supply decreases. And that's really what we want to have happen. Less foreign cars in our market, right? So we force a tax on foreign cars and their supply into the U.S. decreases. How does that affect the overall market? Well, here is where the price should have been if there weren't any taxes. Notice that that's the equilibrium price. We know what's going to happen. We're going to move up to our new one, but how does it happen? Well, first, when the supply decreases, what happens? Well, the price of the cars, they don't go up right away. They hang out a little while because right now the supply is less than the demand. Since the demand at that price is greater, we start to see a shortage. And the shortage of cars means that price goes up. And since supply is what moved, right? Supply decreased. We're going to move up to our new price along our demand curve to our new equilibrium. And remember, it's the quantity demanded decreases until we get to our new price equilibrium. And notice what happened to foreign cars. Exactly what you expect to have happen when a price gets tacked onto a good. The price is going to go up. So the price would have been here if we weren't taxing the imports. And instead, it moves up to here. And that's a good thing because what happens? Well, that takes us to example number two. Let's look at the domestic car market and let's assume that the price of foreign cars goes up. Seems like a natural thing to examine, right? Here's our supply and our demand. Well, what's the relationship between domestic cars and foreign cars? They're substitutes of each other. If you're not going to buy a foreign car, you're going to buy a domestic one. So what happens when the price of a substitute goes up? Price of a substitute, that's a non-price determinant of demand. Therefore, our demand for domestic cars increases. So, demand goes up, or demand increases is a better way of putting it. And the demand curve shifts to the right. So here's our new demand curve. Now, again, same old, right? Here's our original equilibrium. What happens at this new price, at this new demand for the old price? Well, we see that our demand is greater than our supply. Demand greater than supply? Shortage still. If you have a shortage, what has to happen? Same thing. Price rises. Except now, price is going to rise along the supply curve because it's the demand that shifted. So we move from our old equilibrium to our new equilibrium along the supply curve. And our quantity supplied increases. To our new equilibrium. And so what we see is one of the classic examples of what happens when you tax imported goods. It is good. Why is it good? Because notice what happened to the foreign car, to the domestic car market. How many domestic cars are we selling? Here was our old domestic selling amount. Here is our new one, right? We sell more American cars. But what do you notice about the price? higher. Higher. So it's good for the American car market. The American car market will sell more cars, but at the same time, the price is going to be higher. Not just for the domestic, not just for the foreign, but also for the domestic, right? For the foreign, the price is higher because the supply got cut off. For the domestic, the price is higher because the demand gets inflated. This is a classic example for how to deal with changes in supply and demand and how they are ultimately going to change the price.